हेलो, गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स. गुड आफ्टरनून टू ईच एंड एवरी वन ऑफ यू गाइस. गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स. गुड आफ्टरनून टू ऑल ऑफ यू. सो प्लीज आस्क योर फ्रेंड्स टू ज्वाइन द क्लास गाइस. वी गोना स्टार्ट द कहूत सेशन बेसिकली टुडे, ऑलमोस्ट अनदर 2 to 3 मिनट्स. गुड आफ्टरनून सहाना. गुड आफ्टरनून सौम्या. सो गाइस, आई एम जस्ट लॉन्चिंग पोल. प्लीज एवरीवन टेल मी, कैन यू एबल टू हियर मी क्लियरली, एंड इज द स्क्रीन इज विजिबल टू ईच एंड एवरी वन ऑफ यू? Everyone try to answer, guys. So please inform your friends that there will be Kahoot session so that they can also join. So I'll be giving you the game pin in some time, okay? So before giving me, let me show you that how the class will be going. So we're gonna start the class in another 2 to 3 minutes, guys. Please ask your friends to join the class if they have not joined. So in your school, is the tests are going on? Good afternoon, Soumya. Good afternoon, Sahana. Good afternoon, Varsini. Okay, so most of you are saying that I'm clearly audible. That is really nice. Good afternoon to you two live students also. Good afternoon, Gopika. So please inform your friends to join the class, guys. Okay. So are you guys started solving the questions from module? Is the module questions are almost done? Is it like that? Good afternoon, Srava. Good afternoon, guys. Please inform your friends to join the class. We're going to start the class in another few minutes. It's already 3 o'clock, students. Okay, yeah, so is it the test going on? Okay. Okay, guys. No problem. So we're going to do Kahoot session today, guys. Before going with the Kahoot session, so I'm just ending the technical poll. First of all, most of you are saying that I'm clearly audible and my screen is also visible. That is really nice. Let us proceed ahead then. Okay. So our today's class will be, first of all, what we'll be doing is nothing but we're going to do some basic plans of magnetic effect of electric current revision. Okay. We're going to do a little bit understanding about what all things we have learned in this chapter. And what all types of questions are going to come with from this chapter? What are all the branches of this chapter, right? Then we're going to start with Kahoot session, guys. Till then, I can understand that most of your friends will also join. So please inform your friends to join the class because I can see very less attendance. I exactly don't know if test is going on. Is it the test timing is during the time of class only or is it earlier? No idea, but still I can see the attendance is very low. Okay. So please inform your friends to join the class if tests have over. Fine. So then we're going to do the, we're going to start solving questions in Kahoot. And if time is there, we're going to talk a little bit about magnetism and matter. If time is not there, then we can wind up. Okay. So let us start our today's class guide with the basic glance of magnetic effect of electric current. Right. So I'm just going to give you a little bit basic lang. It will take me almost 5 minutes time. So try to understand it and make sure that you have paper, pen. Okay, and if you want to have calculator with you, you can keep, but try to do most of the calculation by yourself only, because in JW or NEET you will be not having any kind of calculator with you guys. Okay, so make sure that you try to have a practice of that. Okay, so basically in our basic glance of magnetic effect of electric current, what we have learned in this chapter, we have divided this chapter into few basic parts, if you guys can remember. So I'm just going to divide those basic parts and make you understand. So magnetic effect. So I'm just going to write magnetic effect of electric current, this chapter number. Okay, magnetic effect of electric current, right? So guys, can you tell me how many we have divided? Yeah, very correct, Emma. So we have actually divided this chapter in 4 divisions. Very easy to understand actually the divisions, guys. Because when we try to understand a chapter in divisions, we know that how much we are covering and what all things we know. And if we directly just learn a chapter, we just try to find that what exactly we are learning and how much I need to learn more, right? So first division in the magnetic effect of electric current, we have been divided in this chapter first, the Biot-Savart law, guys, if you can understand and remember. So we have learned about Biot-Savart law, in which we learned about that there is a smaller wire, and due to this wire, if some amount of current is passing, so at any point I can say that the magnetic field present over there is given by, due to the smaller element, is nothing but dl. So we're going to write db is equal to that is small magnetic point field at point p. So db at p is equal to nothing but mu naught divided by 4 pi multiplied by current multiplied by dl, right, multiplied by b, right, divided by sorry, not b, dl multiplied by r vector, right, dl cross r, divided by vector r cube. So if you guys can remember, this is a vectorial format, right, students? So this is just a normal one of the first part. Under this Bio-Savart law, we have also understood about for different kind criteria, students. Like for a straight line, suppose if a straight line, the wire is going till infinity, and suppose this is my point P, and I have been asked that how much is the magnetic field at point P, very most used formula, which is equal to mu naught divided by 4 pi multiplied by 2 times of I divided by A. Right, where A is nothing but the perpendicular distance, students. So you can see that we have also learned few more things in this Bio-Savart law, that due to a circular ring at its center, how much it is magnetic field value, right? Due to semicircular ring, due to quarter circular ring. So even though circular ring like this, and when the center is passing from here, and you're talking about a point that is at a distance x from here, right? So we have also talked about these all conditions, different kind of conditions comes in Bio-Savart law. That is the first part only, students. Right, the major factor of this part is only nothing but dl cross r, that you need to keep in mind, guys. Now, thus, when we come to second part, if you guys can remember, in the second part, we have learned very deeply about, very good, cyclotron. Good. So that comes under second part, actually. In cyclotron, we have learned, first of all, basic main thing, second part is nothing but how charges moves in a magnetic field, how charge behaves in a magnetic field. Right, student, how charge behaves in a magnetic field. So there are three different types of criteria. Can you tell me what are three different kinds of criteria? So first, magnetic field can go in a straight path, right, students? Then magnetic field can go on a circular path, right? And the third, the magnetic field can go on a helical path, right? So these are the three major criteria that comes with respect to the terms of how the charges behaves when they go under magnetic field. That when we are talking about when electron trying to go inside magnetic field, they try to do a circular motion. That is a basic example. We also got one of few formula, that is R is equal to mv by qb. We also got the formula for time period, students, in which we have got to know that time period is not depending upon velocity or radius. It is independent upon velocity, 2 pi m by qb, guys. If you guys could remember this time period formula, very interesting. This is how, guys, you're going to have a concept of all the conceptual things in mind regarding this chapter. It is one of the easiest method to keep in glance, guys. I hope this will be helping you. Holiday on Wednesday, sir. Is there any holiday on Wednesday? Is there any kind of festival, guys? If there is any kind of holiday on Wednesday, we will see. We have no idea. Okay, so let's move on. Let's come to point, guys. Now the third part has been divided into, so over here we are talking about charges. Now we are talking how wires behave in magnetic field, how charges behave in magnetic field, students. How wires behave in magnetic field, because you know my wires contain electricity, and electricity have most of the charges, millions of charges, right? So how my wires behave in magnetic field? Can you tell me what happens when my wire go to magnetic field, students? If my wire go to magnetic field, I have taught you regarding different criteria, that is force will be developed, right? Right, guys, force will be developed. Very good. Force. And try to remember that force. So force is also developed over here. That is, force is given by Q multiplied by V cross B, students, right? But force over here is nothing but I multiplied by L cross B. They both are the value for force only, but one is the value for force due to charge, one is the value of force due to a wire. Make sure that you remember these all things, guys. These all things needed to be very clear with respect to the concept. So that's why I'm telling you to solve different kind of questions. So today Kahoot session will be there. I want every one of you to participate in that Kahoot session and give answer thoroughly. Make sure, think it like a test, so that you can be very comfortable from yourself that, okay, I'm getting this much time, I'll be able to complete. Okay, I'll be almost giving you some amount of time with respect to particular each of the questions, so that you feel comfortable with the Kahoot sessions. Okay, it's almost like 3 minutes or might be 2 minutes timing I'll be giving you with respect to each of the concepts, each of the questions. And the fourth part, then the last part, if you guys can remember, students. Now, yeah, this week there will be test, guys. This week on Saturday, there will be test. Please inform each and every one of your friends that this week, Saturday, you're going to have test on chapter number 4. Make sure don't leave the test, guys. Please have a habit of attending the test. I can see that most few of the students are not attending the test only. They're thinking themselves, okay, fine. So question number 4, guys, what we can talk about question number 4, this is a part 4. Actually, so in part 4, that concept comes about torque. I hope this is the last topic we have learned. Torque, magnetic moment, students. So we have learned about torque, magnetic magnetic moment. So I hope you can correlate the points whatever I taught you and whatever is the chapter, right? From where the JW or NEET question is going to come very directly. Torque, magnetic moment, right? Magnetic moment formula was nothing but I multiplied by A. You have torque formula is also nothing but I multiplied by A multiplied by B, right? And we have something called N also, if we can add. So these is the basic priority in which our magnetic effect of electric current chapter was totally been divided, students. So I try to taught you this chapter in this format so that you all can easily understand this. And from each of the topic, you can expect questions in a different matter. Okay. So you can see that when we comes to wire, there will be questions like two wires, they're passing from each other and current is flowing. Suppose one ampere, how much is the force of attraction between them? They can ask question like this. Right, guys? So please make yourself very comfortable with the concept plus and write down the formulas, guys. I'm telling you a very good technique. Write down the formula somewhere in the notebook. And then whenever you feel, try to attempt the questions. And whenever you feel that, oh my God, I'm just not able to remember this formula. Watch your notebook and then try to solve the question. Basic priority should be solving the question, not remembering the formula. Keep that in mind. I don't want you to remember the formula and then solve a question. I want you to solve the question and just have an idea about that formula. Okay. Is it clear to each and every one of you guys? That makes us feel more understanding and more comfortable rather than investing time in learning the formula and that such a big formula. I cannot able to learn. I have a very less learning power. Those all things should not come in middle in learning a thing, right? Okay, so let's move ahead with the Kahoot session, guys. So I'll be launching the Kahoot session in front of you. I'll be giving you the Kahoot links. Okay, so Kahoot, I think so everyone knows where to go. So let us try to do Kahoot session, which is an interesting one. So everyone go to this website that is on Google. On Google, go to Google and type Kahoot.it. Try to type Kahoot.it and this is the game pin, guys. Everyone try to join. Google. So I will also type the game pin over there in the WhatsApp group also. So everyone try to join using the same Google pin, students. Everyone try to join using the Google pin. So I hope everyone can see the Google pin. So try to be innovative and use your phone to log in. Go to Google. Go to google.com. Okay. Google.com. Mein type this. No need to type HTTP, just type Kahoot.it and everyone try to participate, guys. I want to see your participation. So I will say you that, let me see. Okay. So most of the students are participating. So only few students are participating. Okay. Other students, please try to participate. Other guys try to participate. Yeah. Good. Everyone. Okay, so I have actually done what the names that will be coming is not with respect to your names. You'll be having your own name. Check with your name. You'll be not added with the same name. You'll be added with different names, guys. Because we find it out that few students, you just use some random kind of name, which is not useful with respect to them. Okay, so I'll just sharing this screen to you, to every one of you, so that you can easily utilize it. Guys, you can see the Kahoot session also. Yeah, that is fine. So everyone can see this, or we are not able to give our names. Yeah, no problem. You just try to log in. No problem. Name will be automatically given to you. Okay. Jagan, name will be automatically given to you. Chapter number 4, this Saturday, they will be having test. So this is a Kahoot session. Everyone try to join. I can see only 15 students have joined the Kahoot session. Why is it so, guys? Please try to join. PIN is 5328305. If you want PIN, I will give you the PIN. PIN is 5328305. So everyone try to join using the given PIN, students. 5328305. Go to Kahoot.it and try to join using the PIN, students. Okay, fine. Everyone, guys. I have just shared the link, shared the pin with you. Do you want me to share with respect to the in the WhatsApp group also? I can share it, students. Just give me a minute. Okay. So everyone try to join. I need at least 40, 50 students, guys. 30 students are there. Where are the students? Try to participate. It will be interesting, guys, if you try to participate in something like this. Don't worry. Just try. Just give it a try, guys. Give it a try. You will feel comfortable after solving questions. Not it, questions won't be that much fun. Tough. So I'm just saying it in the group also. Everyone join first. Okay, so I can see 30 students have joined the class. So shall we start? Other students, guys, everyone try to join. I want every one of you. Are you guys comfortable in joining Kahoot, right? I think so. Pratik sir have made you so much comfortable enough to use Kahoot. But this is some kind of different. I'm just trying to use some different things so that you feel comfortable and you also feel good. So everyone try to join, guys. And I'm going to start the Kahoot session in another 1 minute. Okay, so I'm going to start this. I'll also show you the questions in the slides also. Don't worry, guys. Okay, everyone join, guys. Everyone join, students. Okay, seems good. Very good, guys. Just ask a question. So everyone have got their own name, right? Some different kind of name that has been randomly generated, students. So let's start. Let's start the session. I think so most of you have started, have joined. I hope everyone can see the screen, right? So just a minute. I'll just show you the screen. I don't know why did the screen went ahead. Okay, yeah. So everyone can see the screen, right? So let's go ahead, guys. This is the first question. This is our first question. I hope everyone can see the question. So the first question that is in front of you, us is nothing but there are three straight wires. Okay, it is going too much fast, actually. Okay, no problem. So I'll show you the first question over here. So you can actually see the first question over there. So this is our first question, guys. Can you try to solve the question? The timer is in front of you. And if you cannot able to see the question, please try to see the question over here. I'm just showing you. Okay, so I'll launching the Kahoot over there. Yeah, so now is it properly visible, Nikita? Is it clearly visible now? So guys, those who are playing Kahoot, you can give me the answer over there. I hope timer is there in front of you, right? So I'll just give some sound also, so that you can feel comfortable. So you can see that the timer is running, guys. So first question, so I'll try to explain you the question also, right? So try to see the question here and give me the answer in Kahoot, guys. So timer is running over there. So everyone tried. So I have given timer of almost like more than 3 minutes. Okay, 3.5 minutes almost. So don't worry, you have time. Just try it out. The question says that there are three long straight wires A, B, and C are carrying current as shown in the figure, right? So then we have a question in front of us. There are three long wires that is having a current of 1 ampere, 2 ampere, 3 ampere. They are having current in same direction, guys. Can you see? But the distance between them is D, right? They're asking the resultant force on B, guys. I hope I have made you solve such type of problems in the class. Try it out and try to give me the answer. Which will be the correct option? Option A, option B, option C, option D. Give me the answer in Kahoot. Do you want me to raise option over here also, guys? If you want to give answer, you can give answer here also. Bharat, that is the correct answer. Very good, Bharat. Other students, guys, try to participate. Okay, I can see 35 students have participated. Very good. Pritam, wrong. Jayant, no. Jayant, correct answer. Likita, no. Jagan, that is the correct answer with respect to the answer. Good, Sachin. Monisa, no. Harsha, no. Tanuja, wrong. Check with your answer, guys. Okay, it seems that so guys, I'll give you only 2 minutes time, not more than that, okay? Then I'll try to help you understand the question. Diksha, wrong. Diksha, Sivraj, correct. Shrava, correct. Monisa, wrong. Check with your answer, guys. Think first, read the proper question properly. Normal question they have given, the distance, there are three different kinds of wire that is passing, right, students? and you need to find nothing but the, you need to find the resultant force on B. So first of all, on B, if this, there are three kinds of wires. So I'm just ending the poll, guys, and then I'm trying to make you explain the questions, because it's almost more than 2 minutes, and I can see most of you have participated. 30 students have participated over here in MCQ, and over there also you have participated. That is really good. So only 10 students have given me correct answer over here. So let me check what is going to happen over here. I can skip this or not, right? I can skip, right? I don't want to play this long. We don't have option like that. Okay, let's see. Let's wait for 10 more seconds. Okay. Yeah. So we find it out. The correct option was is nothing but option D. So let me show you the correct option. So 14 students in Kahoot have sent me the correct answer. That is option number D is the correct answer. And in the poll also, I can see the 10 students have given me the correct answer. So option D, towards C is the correct answer. Now, how you will get towards C? Now, that is a question that is matter in front of you guys. So utilize students, I hope you guys are also participating in Kahoot, right? It should not like sirf. Only the, sorry, it is saying game is paused. Yeah, game is paused because I paused the game for time. Okay, I paused the game. Now I'm gonna make you explain this question, guys. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna make you explain this question. Okay, so it will, my Kahoot session will go like this. So for, I will raise the question over there. I'll explain you the question over here, and then we again go back to Kahoot, and then you can understand it in this way very properly. Okay. So you can see that there are three different kinds of wires. So wires are somewhat going like this, right? And the distance between D, they have given, the distance between them is what they have given is nothing but D, right? So the distance between them is D, right? Okay. And the current that is passing from there is 1 ampere, 2 ampere and 3 ampere that they have provided you in the question. Okay. Now they are asking you that how much is the resultant force on B. So first of all, if this is A, this is B, this is C, guys, resultant force, guys. So first of all, A will produce some force on B, right? So let me say that if current is going in this direction, current is going in this direction, current is going in this direction, we use rules, guys, but we can do right hand rule only, but where is the direction of current? We're going to put what, guys? We're going to put our thumb, right? And we're going to curl our fingers. So we're going to get nothing but, you're going to get the magnetic field over here is nothing but in this direction, something like this, right? So obviously there will be some kind of force will be produced over here, right? So you're going to find it out that over here on B, so what is happening? So due to B, he is producing magnetic field over here like this and magnetic field over here as like this, right, guys? Is it like that or not? Tell me. Due to B, the magnetic field over here is cross and over here is outside. You can see them. If I put my finger downward, I'm going to curl my finger. And on the left-hand side, I'm going to get is nothing but coming downwards. On the right-hand side, I'm going to get is nothing but coming outwards. So that is a very normal logic that we have used, right? Yeah, does it matter? On our hand rule, you can change the position of wrist, guys. If it is downside, you're going to, how to make my thumb downside, guys? I need to change the position of my wrist. Don't say that right-hand thumb rule means it should always go like upward. You can easily change the position of your wrist, okay? Fine, good. So this is due to B, guys. So do we need due to B? What we actually need is resultant force due to B. So is this crisscross and dot is the resultant force of B? Tell me, students. Yes or no? Tell me. Is this crisscross or dot is the resultant force? Yes or not? Tell me yes or no. Normal logic, guys, I'm asking you. Crisscross means what is this, Amit? Are you there in first class? Or are crisscross means inwards. Make sure the guys keep these things in mind. If they have written cross something like this, that means the magnetic field. Oh, confused, sir. No problem. Okay, so make sure that keep it in mind. Crisscross means inward. The magnetic field is going inward due to B. Over here, magnetic field is coming outside. If magnetic field is coming outside and magnetic field is coming inward due to B, so are they asking me about magnetic field due to B? Yes or no? No, they are not asking me about magnetic field due to B. This is most of the students got confused over here and do lots of mistakes in such kind of problems. Very clearly, they have mentioned that whatever is the force you need to find is not magnetic force. You're going to find is nothing but the force that is present inside the magnetic field, right? So we are not going to take the magnetic field over here. We're going to take the force. Force formula has been given by force is equal to I multiplied by L cross B, right? L cross B. This is a general formula for force due to a wire, right, students? So if you're going to write with respect to this, we're going to write the magnetic field. So how much is the value? So magnetic field in which this B is there, guys. So tell me, due to this wire A, there is magnetic field on B. So I'm going to say that magnetic field over here will be nothing but outside. Is it clear? Due to A. So I'm going to write what? I'm going to write some very interesting thing. Force due to A on. So force due to B on A. Force due to B on A. So B is trying to produce this much force on A. Is it clear, guys? Are you clear? Just let me know. B is trying to produce this much amount of force on A. So it can be written as nothing but current, that is I2. Let me write the current of this is I2, current of this is I1, and current of this is I3, so that you should not get confused. Current is I2 multiplied by L multiplied by magnetic field, guys. So now this magnetic field, that means this outside fields are coming due to what? These outside fields are coming due to A, guys, right? Due to A. So B due to A, right? So we're going to write mu naught multiplied by 2 times of I1 divided by 4 pi multiplied by perpendicular distance. Guys, how much is the perpendicular distance over here? The perpendicular distance that we guys are having right over here is nothing but D. Is this easily able to understand, guys? You can easily put the value for P. I'm not telling you directly the formula. I'm trying to make you understand how to write down the solution, not based on the formula, based on the concept. So understand it properly, guys. Mu naught divided by 4 pi multiplied by 2 times of I1 divided by A. What is the concept that I want to teach you over here is nothing but this I1 is coming due to magnetic field, and this I2 is coming due to the wire current. Okay, this is the important point that I'm trying to teach you. This I2 is coming due to the wire, and this I1 is coming due to the magnetic field, that you need to keep in mind while solving lots of problems. Student get confused over here, do mistakes and just do mistakes. Okay, so you're gonna write it over here is nothing but mu naught divided by 4 pi divided by D multiplied by, guys, length. I don't know about length, so let me write length as L. No, I know about I1, I2. I1 value is 1 and I2 value is 2. So I1 multiplied by I2, guys, 2, 1s are 2. So 2, 2s are 4. So you're going to get nothing but 4, 4L, right? So you're going to get nothing but 4L. So this is the force due to B on A, guys. So do you think B will be only producing force on A? No, there is some wire also called C, right? So B will be also producing some kind of force on C. So how can we find out the B will be producing what kind of force on C? So we're going to find out in this respect is nothing but similarly, guys, the whatever the value for, first of all, the force will be produced under the magnetic field only. So due to C, the magnetic field that is produced on B, is it inverse or is it outwards? Tell me. Due to C, the magnetic field produced on B. So this was the due to A, the magnetic field produced on A or produced on B. Right over here, due to C, the magnetic will produce. So you can put your thumb in downward direction, and B is towards the left side. So I'm gonna say that magnetic field is towards inward, guys. Right, very clearly. So magnetic fields are inward. So you're gonna make it so that magnetic field is, guys, totally conceptual thing. You don't have to learn lots of things in order to solve such type of question. You just need to understand. Okay, current going, magnetic field will be a very clear thing. Okay, so if magnetic field will be there, force will be produced. So force value will be nothing but I multiplied by L multiplied by B. Right, so we're going to write is nothing but I. So which I? I'm going to write as nothing but I2 multiplied by L multiplied by B. Now, which B, guys? Now, it is not B due to 1. It is B due to 3. It is magnetic field due to 3. So you need to keep these all things in mind. 2 multiplied by I3 divided by 4 pi by D. Everything will be same, student. Just the concept that will be changing is with respect to the current part divided by 4 pi d. So you're going to solve it. You're going to get the value is nothing but I2 value, you know, it is 2, and I3 value, you know, it is 3. So 3 to the 6, 6 to the 12. So you're going to get the same value, mu naught divided by L multiplied by 12 divided by 4 pi d. So this is the force due to C on, now this is the force due to B on C, right? So how much is the net force, guys? Which direction is the net force? Is the net force is perpendicular to the direction of the plane, or is the net force is plane of the paper, or is the net force is towards A or towards C? Can you tell me which one of the force is given? So how to find net force, right? So you can draw the diagram to find net force, guys. So let me draw the diagram. So I have drawn the diagram. This is my A, this is my B, this is my C. So B is applying some force over here, that is force due to BA, and B is also applying some force over here, that is force due to BC. Which of the force is greater? Is the BA force is greater or BC force is greater? By telling me at the, by seeing over here, tell me the answer. Is BC force is greater or BA is greater, guys? Tell me. Try to participate. Students, try to participate. If BC is greater or BA is greater? Utilize, students. Try to participate. Other guys also, guys, please don't just keep quiet, guys. Try to participate. It will be really helpful. So everyone is clear that BC force is greater, because BC force we have 12 times of. And for BA force, we have only nothing but 4 times of. So obviously 12 times will be more better, right? So we can say that the net force that will be acting due to B, right? Since BC is greater, so net force that will be acting due to B will be towards C direction only. This is the net one. Is it clear to each and every one of you? Please tell me, is the answer is clear to each and every one of you? Just let me know, guys. Is this answer is clear to you? Those students who have done wrong, are you clear to how to make it correct now? Right. So make sure that you guys understand where the logic of flowing of current. In same question, they can ask same question, but the current direction they could change. Right. They can change that current is going in upward direction. So obviously the direction will change. Then the force direction will be not in same direction, guys. I hope you guys could remember those all rules. Okay. So if it is clear, students, then we can proceed ahead for solving more questions. Right. So how to find the direction of force? If you're going to find, tell me, ask me that. So I can tell you that in order to find direction of force, very normal thing, put the thumb, put the finger point in the direction of magnetic field, put this part, put thumb in the direction of current. So you can see current and on wire, we see magnetic field is going inside and thumb is going downside. So palm face is going to show you direction of force. So force will be there in that side. That's why I have written F due to BC on the right hand side direction. This is the reason, guys. Okay, so make sure you have to understand these all things and go in a see our hand only, sir. Yeah, good, good, very good. So that's why I taught you only right-hand rule, guys. No flaming left-hand rule, not nothing to confuse. Just use right-hand rule, make confidence with 2 points and you can make this chapter easy to understand. Okay, so I'm going to just share you the Kahoot session ahead now. So please everyone try to answer in the Kahoot after this. Okay, so yeah, let's proceed. So I can see that Legend have given the, and he's the top scorer. So let us, we're going to do resume, right? Yeah, we're going to do resume. So this is, students. So this is our question number two. So you can try this question. So the options will be in front of you guys in the Kahoot. Check it once and we'll be showing you the questions over here. And I'm giving you time, guys. Try to solve the question, okay? So I'll be showing you the questions here, guys. This is question number two, Kahoot question number two. Try to solve this question, guys. This is also a very easy question, students. So I'll launch the poll here also. I'll not give you more than 2 minutes time, guys. So make sure that you try to participate within 2 minutes. Okay. Everyone try to participate. After 1 minute, I'm going to make you understand the question. Shrava, that is the correct answer. Good, Bharat. Good, guys. You guys are giving the correct answer. That is really good. That means you guys could remember the formula. So, guys, make sure that in question, they are writing straight wire, guys. So, that could be helpful for you. Good, Arun. Good. Most of you are giving good, Jagan. Guys, most of you are really giving me correct answer. There could be two possibilities. Either you guys are very clearly making it, or second possibility that you guys have solved the module. These are few questions from your module, students. So it can help you to also make that this Saturday you'll be having test. So make sure that you are comfortable enough to solve question. Very good, Jayant. Very good, guys. So most of you are giving me correct answer, guys. So we will see also in Kahoot. So how many of you participate? 24 students have only participated. At least 30 students, guys. Try to participate in Kahoot. Tanuja, good, good. That is correct answer. Sainika, correct answer, guys. Try to participate in Kahoot. So is there any shortcut method to change the sharing of the screen? Is it like that? You can see that 26 students have participated, guys. It can be more. Try. Okay. Yeah, that is correct. CM. Sir, options are not visible. Okay, Santosh, I'll just launch the poll over there. Means I'll share the screen over there. I hope you can see the options, guys. Good, Harsha. So most of you are giving me correct answer. Very good, guys. I really got a good response. So it's more than 2 minutes. So let's wind up, students. Let's see the correct answer first of all. So I can see most of you have participated. Very good, very good, very good. Almost time is gonna end. Okay. How to proceed forward? I want to skip the question. I can't skip the question. Is it like that? I can, right? Okay. Just a minute, guys. I'm just skipping the question. So I'll try to get the answer, guys. I can see 18 students have given me the correct answer. Kahoot. I don't know why it's not skipping. We can proceed ahead, right? There was option for skip. Where is that option? Seems no option. We need to wait again. Is it like that? Let me just check. Not like that. Okay, no problem. We're gonna move ahead, guys. No problem. After the time. Yep, so we can see the time's almost ends up, guys, and the only 25 of the students have given me correct answer, and I can see Legend Agate is on the top, right? So we're gonna just wait, and we're gonna understand that what is the correct answer for this. So the correct answer for this Kahoot session is nothing but, for this question is nothing but option C, guys. So I can see most of the students have really got correct options. That is very good. And if you can directly use the formula, you can directly apply it. So they are saying that there are two long conductors separated by distance D and having current I1 and I2, right, in the same direction. So two long conductors are there and they're having nothing but the current as I1 and the current as I2, students, right? Now they are saying that, is it like that? It should not be like that, guys. Let me check. Option, okay. Yeah, fine. That is the... that might be the correct option for this was option C, right? Let me check. Most of you have given option C only. I also got option C. Okay, so that might be the Kahoot one. Kahoot, actually, it might be get selected the option D, because according to the option, it should show C. Okay, no problem. Okay, guys, so we'll try to understand it. Okay, fine, no problem, guys. So we'll try to understand it. The correct option, yeah, this can be calculated easily mentally, yeah. So we're gonna find that force is given by how is the force that we used to write is nothing but mu naught divided by 4 pi multiplied by 2 times of I1 multiplied by I2 multiplied by L divided by D, guys. Can you remember this formula? Tell me. Can you easily remember this formula? Now try to put on the values. Whatever values you are having, try to put on the values. They are trying to speak, right? So value they are trying to speak is they exert a force F on each other. Now the current in one of them is increased twice. So suppose this is the first force. Okay, let me take this is the first force. Let me talk about the second force. This is F only. So F dash will be nothing but mu naught multiplied by. So what is have been increased? Current in one of them has been increased twice. So two times of current has been increased. And the direction is it's reversed. So minus 2 times of I1, right, multiplied by I2 multiplied by L divided by the distance is also increased to 3D, guys. So how much they are giving? They are giving the distance that has been increased to nothing but 3 times of D. So we're going to write nothing but 4 pi multiplied by 3 times of D. we're going to try to solve it, and we're going to take the ratio. So we're going to find it out how much is the F1 is equal to F. So I'm going to write F1 is equal to nothing but mu naught divided by I1 multiplied by I2 multiplied by L divided by 4 pi D. This is the value, guys. Multiplied by, we have nothing but minus 2 divided by 3. So I can say this is looking like F. So F1 is equal to nothing but F multiplied by minus 2 times of 3. So the correct answer for this is nothing but minus 2F by 3. Is it clear to each and every one of you? Yeah. I find it out that in quiz, they have given that wrong. C. They have given the answer as D. I will check it out. I'll make sure that it's not happen again. Okay. So because most of you have correct answer, guys, the correct answer is option C. Okay. No problem. Don't worry. Yeah. So we're going to resume with question number 3, and we're going to see that what is our question number 3. So I'm going to show you question number 3 in front of you. Right. So try to solve this question number 3, guys. It is also there in front of your Kahoot session also. I hope you can maximize the question and watch it there in Kahoot also, guys. So everyone is clear, right? Are you guys understanding? So if any doubt, please let me know, guys. This is our question number 3. So this is the quiz that is going with respect to Kahoot, guys. Make sure that you try to give the correct answer. And be participative, guys, and understand the questions. That will be very comfortable, guys. So I think so there is some kind of glitch in this Kahoot session right now, because the timing also with respect to the terms also, we have something different. Okay, so everyone try to give answer, guys. This is an easy question. They are trying to ask in an easy way. I'm going to make you understand the question in a few minutes. So please try to answer. So we're going to solve questions, guys. Okay. So I think so. It's good, right? So this is fine. Going good, right? So are you guys understanding it? And is it helping you to understand this Kahoot session? So I think so. This Kahoot session is going more sweeter than the previous Kahoot session, means in a proper flow, right? Yeah. Okay. So one student have given me the answer. That is Arun. That is fine. Yeah, man, no problem. Okay, Jagan have also given me the answer. That is not correct, Arun, actually. And Jagan also, that is not correct. Pritham, that is the correct answer. Very good, Pritham. Guys, it is an easy problem. Try it out. It's not very tough. Try it out. It's an easy one, guys. Not tough one. Check it out. Just the conceptual thing, guys. This problem is understanding regarding the concept. Check it out once. So you have time, you can check it. In Kahoot also you have time. Shrava wrong, Jayant wrong. So I'm going to launch poll in front over here also. Okay, fine, good. Seems good. Good, guys. Good. Good number of participation I'm getting. That is really nice. Okay, fine. Okay, guys, so I can see that most of you have answered the session as, so I'm going to make you understand. I'll not wait for that much long. Okay. So what I'm going to do is, I can see most of you are giving answer. That is really nice. So I'm going to, so almost times 1 minute time is still there in Kahoot, but I'm going to make you understand over here because we are almost going out of time. We can see how it's slow. I have given you 4 minutes time actually over there. That's a huge amount of time. Okay. So I'm just going to end the poll over here, guys. I can see very less number of students have participated. First of all, only 15 students have participated in this question. Very easy question, guys. This is an easy question, first of all. In this question, I can see 8 students have given me the correct answer, first of all. And the correct answer is option B. Right. So if you're there in Kahoot, don't answer it just fastly. I don't know how to pass it, guys. Should have given some time. Okay. Time's up. It's almost time's up. Yeah. Okay. So I can see that only 11 students in Kahoot have given me the correct answer. That is option B. So I can see Rocky Sark is now in the top. Wow, that's really nice. Okay, guys, so what we're going to do is we're going to try to understand this question. Okay, so most of you have given me option B, that is option B is the correct answer. But how we get option B, guys? First of all, they are saying that there is an electron that is moving in an orbit and having a radius r. You can see this is a single electron having moving with radius r, having a the mass as E electron mass and moving in a radius r around each, right? Time period is given by T, guys. Now the magnetic moment, guys, very easy problem. They're saying, you know the concept. If you know the concept, you can solve it within seconds of time. And if you don't know concept, then it will be very tough to remember all these kind of formulas. You know the concept, that is current is given by charge by time, right, students? I'm going to teach you concept, understand it. So charge is given by current, charge is E, which is given by E. Time period they have given as T. Right. Now they are asking you magnetic dipole. Magnetic moment is nothing but current multiplied by area. Current is nothing but E divided by time period T mod, we can take mod, multiplied by area. You can directly see the correct option is nothing but option B. No need to have any kind of confusion over here. I don't know how can you take such much time, right? So even though students are giving wrong answer, there are few students who are giving me wrong answer. Either they are trying to do lots of calculation or somewhere some concept is not clear in their mind, students. So is this clear to each and every one of you? Please tell me in the chat. Have you understood this? Isn't this was a very easy question? Right, students? Please try to participate. Yeah, forget to cancel. So keep those all things in mind, guys. Please make sure that whichever question you're trying to do wrong, practice it. Just don't leave the question as it is so that it becomes uncomfortable. Okay. So we're going to move to next question. That is our question number 4. That we'll be also moving in Kahoot also. Right. So if you want, you can give answer in Kahoot. So we'll be having not long amount of time. I don't know how to change the time now. I can never change the time. I think so. And I can't find skip button also. Is there any kind of setting like that or something like that? Or having skip button? I don't know. There should be skip button in on every page. There is no skip button. No problem. Leave it. Okay, guys. So I'll just show you question number 5, question number 4 actually. Right. So I'll launching poll over here also. Please try to answer the poll. Yeah. It is an easy question, guys. I'll not give you more than 1 minute time. So I'll not give you more than 1 minute time. I want everyone to answer this question. Easy question, not more than 1 minute time. Try to participate, guys. Even in Kahoot also, I will try to somehow fast forward. I don't know. There was one option of skip. Where that skip option went off? And how is it possible that skip option is not there? Okay, so Pritam is giving answer. Good, good, Srava, good. Good, Pritam. Good, Jagan. So I can see that very few students have participated yet. Guys, it's so. Try to participate, guys. Poll is there in front of you. Only 13 students have tried to give answer. Other students, why? Is it very tough question? Is it like that? Please try to participate. So I can see that Likita, okay, no, Likita, check with your answer once. Guys, question is in front of you that there is a current carrying wire kept across the axis of circular current wire. The straight wire will exert inward force. The force on circular loop, the force on the circular loop parallel to itself will not exert any kind of force on circular loop. There are 4 options. Try to give the answer, understand the question first and go with the logic, guys. Don't just directly give the answer. Utilize all students also. You can also try Gopika and other guys. Please try to give answer. So we can see, we can easily see. So it's almost time, guys. So I'm going to tell you the answer now. Right. So almost more than 2 minutes I gave you, and I can see only 20 students have participated, guys. Why is it so? So the correct answer for this question is nothing but option D. The correct answer for this question is nothing but option D. So guys, those students who have given me incorrect answer, please make sure that you understand the question after understanding the like you have gave you the me the incorrect option. Just don't go like that ki, okay, I have just given you the answer and just keeping quiet and sitting quietly. Very easy question it is like that. Okay, it's not a very tough question. There is a normal circular wire in from wire you are passing the nothing but a normal wire. In circular wire, you are passing a normal wire. So what will happen? Tell me guys. So there is circular wire, in that you are passing normal wire. So what will happen, students? So you know the direction of force. Force is given by nothing but force is equal to I multiplied by L cross B, guys. Right? So if your current direction, and your magnetic field direction are in the same line. So first of all, if there is a circular wire, students, so magnetic field will be passing from inside only. Right, and you are trying to pass wire from inside only. So suppose magnetic field is in this direction and your wire current is also going in same direction, so how much will be force, guys? So I multiplied by lb sine theta. So theta is nothing but the angle between L and B. So L and B angle is how much? 0 degrees. So overall answer will be 0. So you'll be getting force value as 0. So there will be no force exerted on the circular wire just because they both are in same direction. Is it clear to each and every one of you? Tell me. Is it clear to each and every one of you? I can see. Let me check that. Oh, okay. I can go back here, but in quiz, I can't go back. I don't know why. So 11 students have gave me correct answer in Kahoot, guys. Very good. So is this question is clear to each and every one of you, guys? Just tell me. Is this question is clear to each and every one of you? Are you understanding the questions? Okay, very good. Okay, guys. So those students who have gave me wrong answer, please be more focused on understanding where you have went wrong. Okay, so let's move to question number 5. Right? So it is also a very easy question, conceptual question. So there is a charge that is moving through magnetic field. So we have a charge which is moving through magnetic field. The force acting on the charge is maximum when the angle between the direction of motion of charge in the magnetic field is. Very easily they are asking that charge is moving in a magnetic field, when will be the force maximum? If I want to make maximum force, when I can make the force as maximum? Tell me the angle. So I'm just launched the Kahoot session, guys. So in Kahoot, I think so it will be going too much long, so I'll try to just wind it up faster. I don't know, I should have given the permission, right? They should have given me permission to skip. I don't want to go for 230 seconds. And so I have to go. That is the thing. You have passed, sir. Yeah. Now I made it again. Ahead. You can try. Very good. I can see 6 students have tried to give the answer. Very good, guys. Good participation. Other students also. I am launching the MCQ here also. Please try to participate and give me the answer, guys. You can find it very easily, guys. This question is very easy. You just need to remember one logical formula. Very good, Jagan. Very good, Sachin. Arun, check with your answer one. Arun, check with your answer. Might be wrong. Check, Arun. Very good, Sanik. So I'll give you almost more than 30 seconds, guys. Then we will be winding up on this question. Kahoot session, I need to restart once, okay? So I'll be restarting once, then every answer will be gone. No problem, leave it. We can wait, we have time. We have time till 4:15, right? Okay, Pritam. Good. Very good, guys. Very good, Pritam. Nice. Other students, Tanuja, correct answer. Other students, try to participate. It is an easy one, students. Directly on the formula, even though it's for direct on the formula, only 10, 17, 18 students are answering. Why is it so? Where are other students? Direct formula question. It's a direct formula question. Guys, you can participate in Kahoot also. For each question, we are providing you 4 minutes time in Kahoot. Check it once. For today only. Might be next Kahoot session, I'll be providing you only 90 seconds time. Okay, so you can use the Kahoot session. Take your time. Try to give answer. Check whether how much you are correct you are in giving answer. Right? So I'm just ending the poll over here, guys. Still the Kahoot poll is running on. I can see most of the students have given me the correct answer. That is 13 students have given me correct answer out of 21 votes. Fine, no problem. That is a good number. Okay, so I can see that there is a charge moving in a magnetic field. First of all, what happened when a charge moves inside a magnetic field, guys? Suppose if I have a magnetic field over here, and if it's small charge, which we can't see our naked eyes, if I try to move this charge in a magnetic field, it will try to rotate. That is a very type of property we have find it out, right? The reason of rotation is due to the force towards inside. Okay, so there is a force that is towards inside. That's why it is going to rotate, students. Once we got to know that it's going to rotate, so you're going to be more confident about regarding the that at what angle it's going to rotate. So you know the value for force, guys. Force is given by nothing but charge multiplied by V cross B, guys. Most of the students also get confused over there. Ki which formula to use, sir? I have very confusion about these two form of a force, right? So out of these two formula for force, you have a very logical formula. This formula is used only for charges. Okay, guys, and this formula is used only for wires. So make sure that you use correct formula, correct place. Just because they have written force, don't place it anywhere and think that I'm finding force. It will be never like that. Okay, so charge, they have been given charge multiplied by VB sine theta, guys, right? VB sine theta. So when my sine will be maximum, guys, my sine will be maximum. So sine zero is zero, right? Everyone know that sine 0 degree is nothing but 0. So sine 90 is nothing but 1. So I need to get nothing but maximum value. So maximum value means my angle should be how much? 90 degree. 90 degree means how much, students? It will be pi by 2. So the correct answer for this option is nothing but option D. Mm-hmm. Option D, pi by 2 is the correct answer. Those who have given me option D, that is really good. Those who have given some another option, please make sure. Okay, 22 students have gave me option D. That is very good in Kahoot. Okay, and I can see Rocky Sark is on the top. Next time I will be trying to keep your names only, guys. Okay, so it will be more interesting, right? So is this going ahead? Are you guys understanding the Kahoot session? Are you feeling comfortable also? Okay, so we're gonna see next problem then. If you have understood this, we're going to see next problem. Let me see next problem. That is question number 6. Okay, so I'm launching 30 second delay time, guys. I'm not launching Kahoot time and PPT at same time because YouTube Live students are also watching their classes. So I'm making in some kind of delay so that everyone will be comfortable with that class. Okay, so this question, the question that they have provided, that there is two answers. I'll launch the poll first of all here. In Kahoot also, polls has been launched. You can try to give answer if you want to give answer by your own, or you can participate, guys, any means. The question that has been provided, that there are two ions. Each are having of mass 1:1, right? Mass ratio they have given. Charge ratio they have given and projected into a uniform magnetic field perpendicular to the field. Right, so they have given very important line, uniform magnetic field and perpendicular to the field. Speed ratio also they have given, the ratio of radius they're asking of the circular path of the two particle. It's an easy one, guys. You can try it out. I hope you guys could remember hint. How what I can give the hint? Hint can be that R is equal to mv by qb. You can utilize this formula, use this formula and try to get the answer, guys. I want every one of you participate and at least get confidence. Once you know formula, you can get answer. It should not be you know formula and you don't know answer. It should never go like that, guys. Actually, that was a problem from the poll inside. I don't know how it become multiple choice, but leave it for no time being. You select only single answer only. Okay, so that is a problem for at the editing in only. I find it out. That problem. No problem, guys. So this is my second Kahoot session with you. Soon the Kahoot sessions will be far more better and we'll be trying to take classes using Kahoot sessions only so that you guys can feel comfortable. Okay. Yeah. Previous slide. I just saw on the previous slide. Sir. So try to give answer, guys, in the poll. So I'm giving you more 30 seconds time, guys. In Kahoot also time is going on. Almost 2 minutes time is still there in Kahoot. And 30 more seconds in there in Zoom live, then I'm going to make you understand. Pritam. Okay. Pritam is giving some answer. Other students also try to participate. That is the correct answer, Pritam. Very good. Other student guys, please try to participate. Very good, Jagan. So it's an easy question, right, students? You can participate and get me the correct answer. Very good. Okay, guys. So if you have understood this, so shall we proceed? Yeah. Right, students. Fine. So what we're gonna do right now is nothing but we're gonna good, Shrava. Good. Sasang, check with your answer. Wrong answer, Sasang. Likita, correct answer. Arun, correct. Arun, now previously you were incorrect. Now you're correct. Just a minute. I'll be sharing. Yeah. So you can see that the correct answer for this, first of all, in the poll. So I can see only 17 students have voted. Out of 17, 7 students have given regarding option A. So the correct answer for this is nothing but option A only, guys. Okay. So they have given the radius, guys. So suppose R1, they have given you all value. R1 by R2 value, they have given nothing but 1 by 1. Right? Q1 by Q2 value they have given is nothing but 1 by 2. And V1 by V2 value they have given is nothing but 2 by 3, guys. Students, you can see they're asking how much is the value for radius. So R1 is equal to M1 divided by V1 multiplied by Q1 multiplied by B multiplied by R1 by R2, students. R1 by R2 is nothing but Q1 multiplied by B divided by, sorry, this is not Q1, this is Q2, students. Right? Divided by, so just let me check the Kahoot session. Okay, fine. So I can see most 16 students have given option A. That is really good. Okay, so Q2 multiplied by B divided by nothing but you will be having M2 multiplied by V2, M2 multiplied by V2. So you can see that B magnetic field is going to get cancelled. You're going to left with is nothing but M1 divided by M2 multiplied by V1 divided by V2 multiplied by Q2 divided by Q1. So these all values will be left out. Right, so M1 divided by M2, students. What is M1 divided by M2 is nothing but 1 by 1 multiplied by nothing but V1 by V2 is nothing but they have given is nothing but 2 by 3, right? So we know V1 by V2 is 2 by 3, guys. V1 by V2 is 2 by 3. And Q2 by Q1, guys, it is 2 by 1. So I'm going to get value is nothing but 4 by 3. So this is the value for R1 by R2. Is this clear to each and every one of you? Tell me, students, is this clear to each and every one of you? So have you understood this? Just let me know, guys. Have you understood this? Let me know, students. Okay. So you can tell me in the chat, guys. So yeah, A is the correct answer, guys. A is the correct answer. The correct answer is A. Very easy question. They have given you all the ratio. You just need to put it in the values and get me the correct answer. Okay. So let's proceed forward. Let's proceed forward with question number 7. We have still time, guys. So question number 7, guys, that I have launched also in Kahoot also. So please try to give answer of question number 7. Everyone, try to give answer of question number 7. The poll is in front of you. You can take your time. Okay. So I'm just launching the poll. Take your time. Try to give the answer. It is also an easy question. A little bit calculation, guys. So there is an electron who is having some kind of charge and it is moving at right angle to uniform magnetic field. So it is moving at right angle with 90 degree with this. The time taken by electron to complete a circular orbit. So how much is the time taken by the electron to complete the circular orbit? A very sure shot direct question, guys. A very sure shot direct question. You can expect such type of question in NEET. Don't expect in NEET, in JW, because JW is going to go a bit deeper in from this. Okay, but in NEET, you can expect it is an easy question and you can directly expect, guys. But you need to remember the concept for solving question. If you don't remember the concept, no use of it, guys. Try to participate in Kahoot as well as here, student, both sides. Whichever place you find comfortable. YouTube Live students also, Gopika, try to participate. Okay, seems good. So, yeah. That is correct answer, Jagan. Very good. Other students also, I'll be giving you one more minute time. Please try to participate. Only 15 students have participated till now. Why is it so? Where are other guys? Shrava, wrong. You have done a wrong calculation, Shrava. Check with your option. Shrava. Okay, guys, so 10 more seconds, 20 more seconds. Yeah, right. Now it's correct, Shrava. Very good. Very good, Shrava. It's an easy sure shot question, guys. You can directly write it down. make sure that you solve questions, guys. Don't just keep quiet and sit. Even if you though you are not trying to give me the answer, at least you try to solve the question. If you're going to just sit simply and think that you're going to solve all the questions just like that, it is never going to happen. You need to give time from yourself. Right? Guys, it's a direct question. You can easily solve it. So I'm just ending the poll. I can see that only 17 students have till now answered. That's not good. Okay. And poll will be automatically ended there in the Kahoot. So the correct answer for this is nothing but you're going to get answer is nothing but option D. Right. So first of all, how are you going to get such answer? Right. So you're going to find out what all things they have given. They've given the value for charge, that is 1.6 multiplied by 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb. Right. They have also given that it is going nothing but an angle 90 degrees. So good. Right. Sine 90 degree, guys. Good. So it is good to have 90 degree angle. No need to have any worry. It is going to take circular path. Right. Now they have given the magnetic field value also. B is equal to 3.54 multiplied by 10 to the power minus 5. They're asking how much is the time period, guys. Time period is nothing but 2 pi m by qb. Right, 2 pi m by qb. Guys, if you can remember the formula. So 2 pi multiplied by mass of electron is nothing but 9.1 multiplied by 10 to the power minus 31. Right. So keep these all things in mind, guys. Divided by what are all the values? Charge they have given 1.6 multiplied by 10 to the power minus 19 multiplied by magnetic field is 3.54 multiplied by 10 to the power minus 5. So we are getting these all values, and when we're trying to go to solve this, you're gonna get answer is 1 microsecond. That is 1 multiplied by 10 to the power minus 6 seconds, which you're gonna get is nothing but 1 microsecond. Is it clear? So the correct option for this is nothing but option D. I can see that. Most of you have tried to participate. That is very good thing. Okay. Is this clear to each and every one of you? Please tell me, students. Is this clear to you guys? If it is clear to you, just let me know, students. Is this is clear to you? Okay, good. So we have another question. We can move to next problem, guys. Question number 8. So you're going to see question number 8 is nothing but we have. So I'm going to launch poll. Take 2 to 3 minutes time. Try to participate. So this is the last question of today's class, guys. Okay. This is the last question of today's class. So after this, we're going to launch NPS. So don't leave the class now only, guys. I can see 5-6 students have left the class. And that's not good behavior. This is same question, but opposite nature. They have given the mass of electron over here. They have also given the charge of electron. That they have given that it is moving a circular path. They have given us the value for radius. They have given us the value for velocity. You have to find the value for magnetic field strength. Direct formula, R is equal to mv upon qb. Right? So you can easily find the value for B from here, guys. So B value can be written as nothing but mv divided by rq. You know radius, you know charge, you know velocity, and you know mass. Put it in the formula and get the answer. Take your time. This is the last question, guys, of today's class. Next 2 questions will be given you as a homework. Make sure that you solve the question. I'll be sharing you the solution. And tomorrow, we're going to start with new chapter, guys. That is magnetism and matter. Okay, so from tomorrow onwards, we're going to start new chapter. That is our chapter number 5. That is not a very big chapter. And it is a very smallest chapter and very easy chapter to score marks with respect to NEET, guys. Okay, with respect to JEE, don't expect very rare question comes from this chapter. But one question comes. Okay, but NEET, lots of questions come from this chapter and easy way to score marks in NEET. Okay, so make sure that you understand that chapter, magnetism and its matter. Okay, so Shrava have given me one answer. That is really good. Please try to participate and get the answer, students. So 2 questions are there, very easy question. You can easily solve them in home. So I'll be giving you those 2 questions as homework. Okay. Good one, Srava. Sanika, good one. Vaisnavi, check with your answer. Vaisnavi, check with your answer. Preetam, check with your answer once. Sivraj, correct. Jagan, correct. Good, guys. So see, you even now you can see that even you are taking 2 minutes time, but still there are some parts where you are doing wrong calculation. So you need to be more frequent and more good in calculation part. Vaisnavi, check with your answer. Jagan correct, Jayant correct. So guys, lots of time have been provided to you. So I can see that most of the students have given me correct answer. That is option A. How to find the correct answer for this is nothing but we just near gonna put the value. So B is equal to mass 9.1 multiplied by 10 to the power minus 31 multiplied by 1.6, velocity is nothing but 10 to the power 6 divided by radius is nothing but 0.5 multiplied by charge 1.6 multiplied by 10 to the power minus 19. You can even mass the powers, guys, and get the answers. You just need to divide, multiply 0.5 by 1.6, which you're going to get nothing but. See, what is the cost? How to solve this, guys? So, see, here I have minus 31, here I have plus 6. What I'm going to get? Tell me. So, let me put this 25 in upper side, right? So, I'm going to write 9.1 multiplied by 10 to the power minus 25, right? So, we have nothing but 10 to the power minus 31 multiplied by 10 to the power, see, 19 will go in top, so it will become plus, so 10 to the power 6 plus 19 is nothing but 25. So 10 to the power plus 25 divided by, so 1.6 multiplied by 0.5 is nothing but 0.8, right? So you're going to solve this, guys. The 9.1 divided by 0.8, you're going to get answer is nothing but 1.13 multiplied by 10 to the power plus 5. Is it clear to each and every one of you? After this, sir, please show us leaderboard. Yeah, I'll show you the leaderboard. No problem. So, guys, this is the last Kahoot session. Okay. So, I'm just launching NPS to every one of you. Please try to fill NPS, guys. I'll show you the leaderboard also, guys. Don't worry. Just a minute. Oh, my God. Before leaderboard only, it went ahead. We need to wait 4 more minutes. Okay. So, till then, guys, any doubt in today's class, please tell me. If you have any kind of doubt in today's class, guys, today's Kahoot session, I'll be just ending it up. Sir, when I calculated, I got answer as option C. Yes, sir. Right. So now how you got to know, right? What is the correct answer? Now you got to know what is the correct answer, right? That is very good. Everyone try to fill. Guys, the next time Kahoot session, I will try to give a small amount of time, only 90 seconds or 2 minutes. And I expect more number of participation in next class, guys. So I wish that you guys, school examination goes in a proper way. I don't able to see. Okay. So that's all for today, guys. Any other thing, any other doubt that you are having? So I'm just closing the Kahoot, guys. Leaderboard, I will show you actually after, while going inside. I can't show you from here. Yeah. So let me tell who is the... Yep, so I got the leaderboard. I can show you in front of you. Okay. So these two questions will be your homework. Try these two questions as a homework, okay? This is a homework question and this is also a homework question. Try these two questions as a homework so that no one should feel difficulty. Okay, guys. Thank you, guys. I'm just showing you the leaderboards. Check out the leaderboards. So Rocky Sark, who was the Rocky Sark? You have got maximum amount of points, that is 6,490, then Silver Horse. So next time I'll keep your names only, okay? Then cut hand. Okay, guys. Thank you so much. Oh, nice, Jagan. That is really nice. Very good, guys. That's a nice one, actually. Okay, students. So we can wind up for today. We'll meet there in next class. Next class, we'll be starting with new chapter. Make sure you inform your friends that new chapter is going to start. So don't miss the class and understand the class in a properly way. Okay. Oh, nice. That is really nice, Likita. So your name was Magic Lobster. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. No, Eltered First. So this is also good, right? Oh, 6th position. Yeah, nice. So who was Magic Lobster? We have something, someone called Q10 also, and we have someone also called Growing Lobster also. Okay, that's fine. Okay, guys, so we'll meet you tomorrow. Okay, make sure you revise these questions, practice it out. These are questions from your module only. Make yourself prepared this Saturday for regarding the test of the chapter. Okay, thank you. Acha, magic lobster Harshvardhan. Okay, Harshvardhan got to know. Nice, Harshvardhan. Okay, guys, thank you. Thank you so much. Bye bye. Thank you, Udilak students. Thanks. Thank you. You guys.